truck fire in Bourne, and that night in Bourne, the house fire, and... Yeah.
This cloud follows you around, yeah.
Hey, good days and bad days.
Past the financial board, we're extremely pleased and thank these men and women of the department for all their hard work. I know that they went over and above Call of Duty over this storm. This was a tough one.
You'd also like to see us.
And then dealing with an engine that's pretty stressful all in itself. Well, I'm sure.
I'm so glad he's home.
Please,
there's a letter from the in your packet. I didn't copy it for everybody. From John Solano. We can't honor his request because it's an ethics violation. But Greg wanted you to know that they made the offer.
Well, let me read this into the record. We got a letter here from Mark Anthony's. Dear Chief Goodwin, we'd like to take a minute to thank you and all you do for us and our community. We would ask that in lieu of payment, I guess they must have got food there
for the
firefighters. It's in lieu of payment for the recent orders that the fire department placed. Could you please make your check payable to the firefighter injured during the storm? Our thoughts and prayers are with him and his family, and he has copies of the receipts, and he signed it, John Salerno. You know, we would love to honor that, but I know I...
Anything over $50?
Yeah. I would be more than willing to take up a collection ourselves personally, but, you know, this, you know, being district money, you just can't. Even though, you know, most citizens would find no problem with that, but it's ethically, yeah. It's a problem.
Yeah, I just saw that briefly. It was pass it to.
Okay, but again, that's. We'll pass it on to Ray and he sent it.
They can send something to Paul McCann. He can send it directly to the fire.
When the check is cut to Mark Anthony's, Ray's going to hand deliver the check and thank them and just explain to them the rules of
Mark Anthony wants to donate that money.
Well,
so,
there's a fundraiser, which, in the future.
He can do that, but
he can't even donate it to the individual firefighter.
But if he wants to make that donation, once he receives payment, Mark wants to donate it to the family, then he can,
he can't do it. His
business check or something, he can.
That firefighter can't accept it individually.
No. He can donate that check to the fire department as a whole, but not to an individual.
Yeah. Correct. We're all just glad that he's home and he's alive and he's.
Yeah,
I assume he's going to have a way to go, but hey, being home is a big step. But any other questions or comments?
I am going to see him tomorrow, probably, on the branch vehicle to his family. So, or pass the word along.
Yeah, definitely. We're thrilled that he's home and if he needs anything during this, then we'll be certain to try to help him in any way we can. Well, thank you, Billy.
You're welcome. Thank you. That's it with me. I'm good. I'm going to go back.
Thank you,
Billy. Fire Station Building Committee.
We had a real mat in the last 2 weeks, but we still were waiting on the hours. We can't, they're not supposed to join anything.
Yeah. It's up in the air for next week.
No. Unless he's got company report, there's no reason for the committee to meet until that other piece is taken care of.
I believe that the
There's a new person that came into the meeting.
Oh.
We need to read her into the record.
Could you give us your name and affiliation?
Yes. Hi, I'm Lydia Gerner. I'm from the Wareham Week newspaper.
Thank you. Thank you, Lydia. Welcome.
Thank you.
I like seeing the newspaper here. I believe that the attorney is working on that document along with our clerk.
The HR, yes.
project manager?
Yes.
I emailed Nancy Campany today.
So that's in the process?
Yes.
Other than that.
I'm just waiting on that.
It's amazing how, slowly the wheels have.
Just came along.
Yeah, it just, yeah.
I know, it was almost like, we were saying how good we were moving along, and then to have that happen.
Nothing's ever simple. We know that. Item six.
We have to open the meeting, please.
Yeah, now they can open their meeting.
Open the meeting of the Water Commissioner. Roll call. Daniel, Jim, present, and Kyle.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Acting. And the.
4:20.
Water Commissioner, 4:20.
Number five.
We're actually.
Number six.
We're on number six.
We're on number six, but do we want to go back to item three? Item three was public comment, we had a question that was brought up, and I'll let the person, Lisa, if you want to explain your question.
Not really a question, but I made a request of the Prudential Committee to ask for Mr. Hughes' resignation as a non-resident of the district, and in fact may not have been a resident of the district at any time during the current term.
That's news to me. And no, I won't for that.
Okay, that's.
I'm not resigning.
Again,
Well, I think that it deserves more than just it's news to me.
Can I answer the question here?
It's not up to me to ask a question. It's up to the chair to ask you whether.
The statement was, will I resign or not? I'm not resigning.
I didn't. Charlie has to ask that question, but he can ask you where you live and where you've lived since you were elected.
I live in Wareham.
Did you live in the district when you took out your paperwork to the office?
That what address?
I live in Wareham. I'm giving you my address.
No, I. What?
It's public knowledge. You can go right ahead and find it.
I do. I have all of that. But the question is, what was your address on your nomination papers?
You can find that one, too.
I've made a public request for that, and I haven't been given the paperwork. You just don't want to tell us where you used to live?
I don't want to tell you where I live or where I used to live or anything.
If the chairman asks you, then you have to respond.
He does not. He does not have to respond. We have no control. The Prudential Committee has absolutely zero control, other than fiscally.
This is a joint meeting, but we don't control their meeting.
Over the actions of the Water Commissioners. It's a separate entity of the district.
Right. But the clerk treasurer certifies the election.
Well, that's, did you want to address?
I'm sorry?
Do you want to address, you certified that he lives at that address, right?
Mr. Hughes signed a document stating what his address was.
And that,
and
you know.
I, for the years that I have been here, the only time that I have asked for certification from the clerk's office is on a petition article. I know at one point I had made a mistake on the ballot, and I called the Secretary of State office for advice on how do I correct my error. And Secretary Galvin's office said to me that we run our own election and they have no jurisdiction over our elections. So I called Attorney Murray and asked him for his advice. He said it was an honest mistake and that if I had to do another election, it would be done. When you were on, yes. So I have never had, the only time I've had certifications done on in my position was on a petition article.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's fine. You know, that's the procedure we've always followed, right? You know, I don't think, I've only been here 6 years, so I don't, never happened in my tenure that anyone questioned residency of any board member, but I do know that as far as boards, the water commissioners are a separate entity, and if a member of the board says that they were living in the district at the time of filing, then it's a moot point for me unless someone can prove beyond a reasonable doubt something else.
Can I say something? Yes, it did happen a few years ago, you might remember. Yeah. Tony Mueller.
Yeah.
That before
was a
my
big,
time.
Big with Tony Mueller.
Yeah.
Because he had a girlfriend that he spent some time with, yet he lived with his mother right there on
Highland
Ave. That was his mailing address. Where he put his head sometimes was not
at the mailing address.
The business of that was the response we got from the Secretary of State. His mailing address was Highland Ave at his mother's house.
Yeah,
that went on for like 2 years. That was horrible.
You think things happen, you know, they cause temporary relocation. Mm-hmm. You know, that's part of the life.
It's my personal life, it's my personal life.
Who am I to challenge it? And I won't. I think it's, as far as I'm concerned, I don't know about the rest of the board, it's a done deal.
You have to go by what was put in. Person says they
I'm not going to
when they took off their papers
say that someone
elected,
is
untruthful. If they move
that
in the interim, I think when their term is completed, then they do have to go, you know, they can't be applied because they're not living in the district anymore.
So if I may, I can just tell you the information.
I think the discussion is over. But thank you for bringing it up. And, you know, you can produce some other kind of proof. You can follow whatever avenue you feel is necessary. But, you know, as far as this board is concerned, it's a moot point. Okay, item six. Discuss compensation plan with district employees. I think this is the beginning of a discussion that came out of negotiations with the fire union. And now we're entering into negotiations with the deputies to get an agreement, employment agreement, as to how to handle comp time. It has never been addressed by the district. It's kind of been going on for since time started. But things have changed over the years with the Fair Labor Standards Act and other legislation that now affects how we compensate certain employees for hours over and above. The union, it's cut and dry. They get overtime for all hours, but for the engineers, it's not. And we need to, at some point, start seeing what other districts and other communities are doing. Because, you know, you either pay them or you give them compensatory time off. But if you give them time off, then you're paying someone else to fill their position. So, you know, to me, it just seems like pay them here, pay them there. But, there are some employees that have been keeping track of their compensatory time and the numbers needs to be addressed. It's a, it's a,